No more. And I sleep to see me end the heartache and a thousand natural shocks that flesh is heir to. 'Tis a consummation devoutly to be wished to die.
My lady, how does your honor for this many a day?
I humbly thank you well. Well. Well.
My lady, I have remembrances of yours that I have longed to re-deliver. I pray you not receive them.
No, not that I never gave you aught.
My lady, you know very well you did. And with them, words of so sweet breath composed as made the things more rich. Their perfume lost. Take these again, for the pour to the noble wine, rich gifts by sprinkle pour, and give us proof on kind there, my lady!
Virtue cannot so inoculate our old selves.
more deceived.
Get thee to a nunnery. Why wouldst thou be a breeder of sinners? I am myself indifferent on this, but yet I can accuse me of such things that it were better my mother had not borne me. I'm very proud and revengeful, ambitious with more offenses at my earth than I had thoughts to put them in. Imagination to give them shape, time to act them in. What should women as I do crawling between heaven and earth? Our errant needs all. Where is your mother?
At home, my lady.
Let the doors be shut upon her, that she may hang a fool nowhere but in her own house. Farewell!
Oh, help her, you sweet heavens!
If thou dost marry, I'll give thee this plate for that dowry. Be thou as chaste as ice, as pure as snow! Thou shalt not escape calumny! To another go. Farewell. No, or if thou wilt me marry, marry a fool. For wise women know well enough what monsters you make of them. To a nunnery go, and quickly to farewell.
Oh, heavenly power restore!
I have heard of your paintings too. God hath given you one face, and you make yourselves another. You dig, and you amble, you lisp, you nickname God's creatures, and make your wantonness, your ignorance go too. I'll no more on it. It hath made me mad. I say we will have no more marriage. Those that are married already, all but one shall live. The rest shall keep as they are. To a nunnery. Go. Farewell.
Oh. What a noble mind is here o'erthrown. Pointiers, soldiers, scholars, eye, tongue, soul. The expectancy and rose of the fair state. The glass of fashion and the mold of form. The observed of all observers, quite down. And I, of ladies most deject and wretched, that sucks the honey of her music vows, now see this noble and most sovereign reason. Like sweet bells, jangled out of time and harsh. The unmatched form and feature of blown youth, blasted with ecstasy! Oh, woe is me to have seen what I've seen.
Such. a pickaxe and a spade for and a shrouding sheet, or a pit of clay for to be made, for such a guest is meet.
I will speak to this fellow. Whose grace is this, sirrah?
My lady.
A pit of clay for to be made. Such a guest.
I think it be thine indeed, for thou liest in it.
You lie out on it, and therefore 'tis not yours. But for my part, I do not lie in it. That 'tis mine.
Thou dost lie in it. But to be in it and say 'tis thine, 'tis for the dead, not for the quick. Therefore thou liest.
'Tis a quick lie, lady. 'Twill away again from me to you.
And what man dost thou take it for?
For no man, lady.
What woman then?
For none neither.
Who's to be married in it?
One that was a woman, lady. The rest her soul, she's dead.
How absolute the name is. We must speak by the card of equivocation. How long hast thou been grave maker?
Of the days in the year, I came to it that day that our last King Hamlet overtook Hordenross.
How long is that since?
Cannot you tell that? Every fool can tell that. It was that very day that young Hamlet was born, she that is mad and sent into England.
Aye, Mary! Why was she sent into England?
Why, because she was mad. She will regain her wits there, or if she do not, 'tis no great matter there.
Why?
She will not be seen in her there. There the women are as mad as she.
How came she mad?
Very strangely, they say.
How strangely?
Baking with losing her wits.
And upon what ground?
Why, here in Denmark. I have been a sexton here, woman and girl, 30 years.
How long will a woman lie in the earth that she brought?
Faith, if she be not rotten before she dies, we have many copy corpses that will scarce hold the laying in. She will last you some 8 year, or 9 year. A tanner will last you 9 year.
Why, her more than another?
Why, her hide is so tanned with her trade, that she will keep out water a great while. And your water is a care of your worse than dead body. Here's a skull half laid in the earth, 23 years.
Whose was it?
A horse of mad fellows it was. Whose do you think it was?
Nay, I know not.
A pestilence on her for a mad rogue. A port of flagon of Rhenish on my head once. This same skull, lady, was Lady York's skull, the king's jester.
This.
You that?
Let me see it.
What's that, my lady? Dost thou think
Alexander looked up this fashion in the earth?
Even so?
And smelt so? Bah.
Even so, my lady.
To what base uses we may return her issue? Why, may not imagination trace the noble dust of Alexander till she find it stopping a bumble?
It's hard to consider, too curiously to consider so.
No, not a jot, but to follow her thither. With modesty enough and likelihood to lead it as thus. Alexander died, and Alexander was buried. Alexander returneth to dust. Dust is earth. And of that earth we make loam. And why of that loam whereto she was converted, might not they stop a beer barrel? Imperious Caesar dead, and turned to clay. I'd stop a hole to keep the wind away. Oh, that earth which kept the world in awe should patch a wall and expel the winter's flaw. That's soft. That's soft.
Anything, obey it.
I will forestall that repair hither and say you are not fit.
No,
not a bit. We defy augury. There is a special providence in the fallen sparrow. If it be now, 'tis not to come. If it be not to come, will be now. And if it be not now, then it will come. The readiness is all. Since no woman of aught she leaves knows, but is it to leave betimes? Let be.
Oh, threads of angels.